Everybody, my name is Steven, and welcome back to Storytime. Without wasting any time, let's get into our first story of the day. I really don't work on this cruise ship, lady. A few years back, my significant other and I were lucky enough to win a free 3-day cruise to Japan. We live in Shanghai, so we packed our bags and head out to the port to begin our merry Japanese adventure. Since we had won the cruise, we were treated like the other VIP members on the ship that paid top dollar for their tickets. Access to the VIP lounge, free drinks 24/7, and round-the-clock service that was actually quite exceptional. What we quickly realized, though, was that I was the only non-Chinese person on the boat that wasn't an employee. I'm a white American and significant other is Chinese. The first situation to arise from this factor was that the other actual employees thought I was the new guy on board who got on in Shanghai. This resulted in me having to explain to several people that yes, I can actually be in this area while the guests are awake because I am, in fact, a guest. The other semi-annoyance that occurred daily were the Chinese guests mistaking me for a staff member. I would constantly get asked to bring towels and fruit to rooms, when the next performance was, when does the casino open, only in international waters, and these people were itching to play baccarat for some reason. The hours of the duty-free store, do you have child sitting services, does the pharmacy have Chinese traditional medicine or only Western medicine? And anything else you can possibly think of. I have been an expat for many years and speak Mandarin, so in the beginning I would politely explain to them that I was on vacation too, and if you look just over there is an actual employee that can assist you. 95% of people would accept that fact and go find an actual employee. About 5% would argue with me that I must be because I am a Laowai, foreigner, and this cruise was Chinese only. They were obviously lovely people. I just figured freak it. I'll play along and have some fun and practice my Mandarin too. It began with a woman asking me to bring towels to a specific room. I said yes ma'am right away, then strolled over to the bar and began at sea day drinking, which if you weren't aware is mandatory on a cruise. Next two people asked for towels and fruit and I assured them that I would make it my personal mission to see to the timely delivery of their requests. Eventually, it devolved into me giving fake directions for how to get to certain stores and restaurants, taking drink orders, being asked some fairly interesting questions about the function of the ship by a kind older man, who gave me a cigarette. He was interested in how the ballast worked on a ship of that size. He was cool, and just general complaining about the service and how they couldn't smoke inside except for the casino. This ship was pretty massive, so I never had to worry about running into these people again and continue to have my fun. When I told my significant other about my dastardly ways, she had a good laugh and encouraged me to continue. She actually suggested I use my Beijing accent that she had taught me. She's a Beijinger. To add a further confusion to the situation, as it is quite rare for a non-native speaker to speak a region-specific passable accent, which I absolutely did. Anyway, this went on for an entire 3 days, including during our trips to inland Japan, as several of the people on our bus had rightly assumed I was a Chinese-speaking employee, accompanying them as a tour guide. At a little town called Sakai Minato, I pulled facts straight out of my butt and was lauded for my immense knowledge of both Chinese and Japanese culture. I was one of the good Laowai. And that's the story of how I got a job on a cruise ship. I can only imagine that it's a difficult situation to be in an area where everyone thinks you're an employee just because of how you look and there's no way to get around that. So a good question for you guys is if you were in OP's shoes here, how would you handle the situation? Would you do the same thing and yank them along? Let me know in the comments below. I don't work here, but I am on a wanted list. This happened years ago and I hope it's worthy of the sub. My cousin worked at a store and she had a big discount on a lot of the items. Most were necessities. So I gave her money to buy things I needed and want. She bought them with her discount and I came to pick them up as she didn't have a car. She left them in the storage area in the back and I went in to pick up the stuff, which required several trips as I was the only one to do it. Lo and behold, a wild Karen appears and seems to think I'm taking out freebies. She tells me she wants some too, but I tell her they're not free and that I bought them. She gets angry and does the idiot Karen maneuver of threatening to have me fired and have my stuff confiscated. This was my last trip and I just call her a fat idiot and to lay off the donuts. I finish loading and drive on home. I don't make a big deal out of it until my cousin comes home and asks me what did I do. Turns out that Karen had some pull in the store and yelled at the managers and had every employee line up in front of her, looking for the big ape that insulted her. The Karen still believes I work there and had even set up a sign on the bulletin boards that has my description and a coupon for any information for my capture. I laughed my butt off and asked what the coupon is for and learned it's for a $5 off any purchase. Purchase must be $25 or more. Dang, anybody got any info on OP? I hear there's a $5 off coupon with my name on it. Wholesome Hot Topic I Don't Work Here Lady. A few years back, I was browsing my local Hot Topic. Say what you will, but I'm rather fond of that store and have been since my teen years. Anyway, I'm looking around and this woman comes up and taps me on the shoulder and asks if I can help her. Not really thinking about it, I just say sure. That good old southern hospitality, you know? She points to my shirt and tells me her daughter loves that show and if I could help her find some shirts her daughter might like. I was wearing a free Iwatobi Swim Club shirt. I walk around the store with her and help her pick out some things. I should also note I've been visiting this particular store since I was in junior high. You know, back when they had the red drippy logo and the black drawstring bags. So I know where everything is. She has a nice little stack of clothes now and texts her daughter to try them on and then asks if I can set up a changing room for her. I just remember kinda laughing and sheepishly telling her I don't work there. She apologized profusely and I assured her it was fine. She asked why I helped her and I remember telling her I was just trying to be nice. It was really sweet actually and she bought me a pin for helping her, even though I insisted she didn't have to. Short and sweet, but still a fond memory. Oh, and I still have the pin. It's always nice to read a wholesome story, and it's nice that OP got a free pin out of it. Being able to look back on a good memory like that is always a nice thing to have, and I'm glad they shared it with us. So my money ain't good enough? Well, I mean, yes, but I really am not the manager here. I was at an Applebee's last year with almost my entire extended family and even some family friends. Needless to say, it was a cluster freak. The occasion was a post-party meal being held after my little cousin's birthday. His birthday wasn't actually the Applebee's trip itself, that came after his birthday at a zoo. 20 plus person party walking around a zoo. Sounds fun, I know. Anyways, I was not actually in attendance for the party because I had an evening class at college during the party, and I didn't even make it to the meal after the party until everyone was already eating. I happened to be dressed pretty well, white slacks and a white button-up with a black belt. Maybe a bit tacky, like a Cuban gangster's outfit, but oh well. I was dressed up for the class actually because we happened to be presenting our projects for computational physics that day. The disparity in my manner of dress and my family's manners of dress that day, having all been dressed to spend a day in the hot sun at the zoo, is really the important detail here. That and the disparity in the time that they sat down. When I arrived, I visited all three of the tables that my family had at the restaurant, said hello to everyone. Before finding my seat, I went onto the bathroom to wash up. Enter an upset and seemingly tipsy, roughly 45-year-old man, who I will call Dom, because he looked like a shorter, fatter Dom DeLuise. Dom stops me on my way to the bathroom. "Sir, let Kaylee know that her tip is shrinking." I still have a false jovial glib on from all the presentation and family interaction mumbo jumbo. Me smilingly, "I'm sorry, sir. Really shouldn't have let myself be so formal. Didn't help." "Kaylee, the waitress? She's let me sit here looking at my empty cup for 20 minutes. What am I supposed to do, raise my goddang hand?" "Kaylee? I'm sorry, I think there is a mistake." "I know they give them fake name tags anymore. The blonde one with the...
kinda creepy."
"Ugh. Look, can you just fill my drink? I had Diet Coke." Kinda showing some confusion here. "Hey man, I'm not actually..." Dom must have assumed I was the manager because he saw I visited with a few tables and because of how I am dressed. "Look, I see you running around going to tables. I know y'all ain't busy. Can't you just get me my drink? Ain't my money any good around here?"
"Mister, I don't work here. I'm just going to the toilet."
Dom is taken aback. "Oh, well, shoot, buddy, my bad." Kinda a lackluster ending, but dang. I feel bad for Kaylee, or whatever her name was, can't recall. Because she waited on me too and she actually had some pretty dang good service. I guess some people go to Applebee's and expect to be treated like hedonism bot. To be fair, personally, I don't even think Applebee's is the place I would expect A+ customer service, just because I feel like Applebee's is kinda in that mold. I know you're washing your dog, but I'm in a local do-it-yourself dog washing spot.
It gets busy on Sunday nights, so I put Doggo's name on the list and wait in line. I love this spot. It has 5 little cubicles and each one has its own tub and drying spot. All the shampoos and conditioners you could imagine and a blow dryer. They even give you little rubber aprons to use so you don't get soaking wet. There is always one person at the front checking people in, cleaning tubs for the next user, and charging people out. Everything else you do yourself. Hence the do-it-yourself description. I'm elbow deep in suds and a super sad border collie when a man pops his head around my cubicle wall. I smile and nod and keep scrubbing. A few minutes, he pops his head around again and looks at me expectantly. It's a little weird, so I ignore him and he goes away. Hooray? Not so fast. He walks around into the cubicle, sighs heavily, raises his eyebrow and puts his hands on his hips. He is like 12-year-old me sassing my mother. Which got me grounded, by the way. I look up startled and he says impatiently, "Can you please stop that and check me out? We've been waiting for ages." I'm a little confused. I say, "I'm sorry, what do you want?" I think he believes I don't speak English. And so he slowly, overly enunciates every word.
"I want to pay."
So I clearly enunciate every word back to him. "I don't work here." He keeps staring impatiently at me. "I'm just washing my dog, you know, like you just finished doing." Just then, the actual employee shows up. She'd been cleaning out a bathtub and calls him over. He at least had the decency to turn bright red, and I'm half sure I heard an apology in his muttering as he walked away. What happened to all that clear diction when it came to my apology? On the bright side, my dog was heaps cuter than his. I do love me a good dog story, especially when OP is taking good care of their dog. Sounds like the poor little border collie didn't exactly enjoy bath time. So let me ask you guys this. Which one of these stories that I read today are your personal favorite and why? Let me know in the comments below. But with that being said, that's all the time we have for today. So thank you so much for listening to and watching the Storytime channel. If you haven't yet, please consider subscribing. And of course, don't forget to let me know which one of these stories were your favorite. Thank you all again for watching and listening to the Storytime channel.